Hello, beautiful souls. Michele McCoy here with Autumn Flow, enjoying the last of the snow here in Arkansas that we never get, and my fingers are freezing. So let's get to this tutorial. I'm going to be teaching you what I am calling the K-roll drop. So I'm going to show it to you and then we will break it down. Okay. So let's get started. This is a K-roll. This is a continuous K-roll. We are gonna be starting in a K-roll position. So the same rules apply for this K-roll transition, which are that you want your arms to stay straight at all times and your palms to be facing in towards the hoop. So you're gonna pop the hoop up with your bottom hand. I like to start with my dominant hand on the top of the hoop. You're going to pop the hoop up with your open palm fingertips. You want to make sure that you pop it towards you, just a little pop. It doesn't really take much. And the lower you pop it, the more control you're going to have over it, the more vertical it's going to stay, and the easier it's going to be to switch, okay? So you're gonna be moving your arms simultaneously. Did I say that already? So again, palms facing the hoop. So you're switching the direction of both palms as you're moving your arms up and down. Isn't this like a super attractive move? Okay. So again, keep your hoop fairly high. You really don't wanna be down here. So I'll come a little closer so you can hopefully see this. So this is how you're cradling the hoop. You're not gripping it. You're just kind of holding it in place here enough so that it stays on a vertical plane. Hopefully, can you see this? It's really fun to combine this move with some other K-roll moves like continuous K-roll, switch, continuous K-roll, go into a chest roll, whatever. It's really fun. So play around with different variations to get into this move. Probably the hardest part of this section of the sequence is regripping in a vertical plane. So start here, regrip, we're here, swing it 180 degrees, bending your elbows. When it gets to your side, let go with your non-dominant hand. Keep the hoop rotating around your body, and when you get back to the front, this is when we're gonna go into the one-handed barrel roll. With my non-dominant arm, I like to kind of just keep it extended for a nice visual appeal. So we're leading with our thumb here. We are rotating our body away from the hoop while isolating our upper body. And then when you're right here, you're gonna take your dominant foot, which for me is my left foot, and I'm gonna plant it facing forward, and then as my hand comes down, I'm gonna drop to my knee and flip the hoop 180 degrees, grabbing it with my non-dominant hand at the bottom. So from this position, this is a really, really good floor position because you can get up real easy, you can move around really easily. When I come down from standing to the ground, that is a transition that I use a lot. So when you're in this position, you can do a lot of things. You can go into a coin flip, you can go into a lasso, pass around the body, you can go into like some foot hooping, which I really doubt I can do with boots on. Hey, look at that. And that is it for the K-roll drop. I hope you enjoyed it and that you are practicing it somewhere warmer.